To solve the problem which we have now of too much matter, we have to understand something more. And for that we need experiment, which we will be going to the space station Mir and observe the experiment which was done on the space station in zero gravity. Here we have a bubble of water, a sphere of water rotating with the bubbles of the air inside. During the time, due to the rotation of the whole system, we see that bubbles go and concentrate around the axis of rotation. We will later explain what is the physics, but first we have to understand the dynamic of the rotation when a liquid and a gas, mixture of gas inside the liquid, rotate all together. So we have this pattern that always along the axis of rotation we have concentration of the bubbles making this cylinder, so all bubbles run to the axis. Here we have a leaves which stay on the surface of the water, but bubbles again go along the axis. Here we have bubbles and also chunks of the vitamin tablets, and we see that these chunks stay on the same position, but bubbles again go along the axis of rotation, making this cylinder of bubbles. So this experiment for me was needed to really understand what's going on inside the star and how. In this video we can see really how big celestial bodies can be, starting from our moon and then to see the planets. Later we will see the stars. Among our planets, our sun planets, we will see how big the Jupiter is. Jupiter is the biggest planet in our system, and that was the best shot of the sun to create another star, but didn't came to be another star. And by seeing this scale of sizes of the stars, we can imagine easily that stars are created by bigger stars. That's the way how stars are created. So bigger stars create smaller stars, and our sun, like a smallest sun, smallest kind of stars, can create only planets. As you can see, there is real giants discovered so far in the universe. And how big we are according to the biggest star so far discovered. Here we can see explosion on the sun's surface, and we can see also that material from the surface which has enough speed to go away from the gravity field of the sun can fly away, but the other part is falling back down to the surface of the sun in a speed of the free fall, and that can happen only when we have matter in a liquid state. So it's also one of the proofs that we have a liquid matter making sun. So the liquid boiling magma is ejected with a speed and goes to create probably new asteroids. And the other part going back, and we can see how it's falling down in a free fall. So we never can see that matter in a gas state can fall down to the surface of the sun in the speed of the free fall. And now we can see from the better perspective what's going on and creation of solar wind, and also how matter flies away from the sun. So we have that clear situation how sun blows hot gases away and creating solar wind. Another view on liquid matter blown away from the sun and constantly creating solar wind going in all directions. In this video we will see something very interesting, a big eruption with a big loop staying for a very long time in this shape. And from the very beginning we see that it's big quantity of the magma erupted in this big loop, but soon enough we will start to see how that magma doesn't have enough speed to leave the gravity field of the sun. So it's small according to the size of the sun, but we can start seeing now how liquid magma falling back to the sun. So this is the clear proof that it is liquid leaking back and falling in a free fall back to the surface of the sun. This is a great example that we deal here with a liquid material, and all around we see a chromosphere, which is part of the sun's atmosphere, this red let's say layer of the sun's atmosphere, but it is clearly visible that this is gas and this is liquid, stays in a certain form and leaking back down to the sun. So this is the proof, clearly visible, obvious, that we are dealing with a liquid matter. To je to. Ništa završili smo. Možda odemo negdje naprijed da... I'm a physicist and my background is Serbian. The reason why we make this video today is my presentation, The Liquid Sun, Entry Gravity Astrophysics, which was held on July 25th this year in the OISE Auditorium here in Toronto. And this is the poster which I was using to promote this event. So this is really once in a few centuries event, because now we are coming again to the another state of our knowledge when we have to make a big change, like we had from the flat earth to round earth, from geocentric system to heliocentric system, and now we are on the very new beginning to change from the understanding of the stars like gas bodies made of hydrogen creating the energy by hot fusion, to another understanding which shows that stars are liquid boiling lava creating energy by using anti-gravity force. I'm a physicist with a revelation of anti-gravity force, which happened to me in 1997. I was still in Serbia, and by looking in a huge fire, I have a revelation that fire is an anti-gravity phenomenon. Trying to understand that through all my knowledge of physics, I have discovered that mass is relative according to the temperature. That way that it can also change not just in quantity, but also mass can change to quality and become repulsive. In 2000 I have published my paper in Journal of Theoretics, and the same year I was presenting that paper in St. Petersburg on Scientific Congress, and after that I started to write book. My book is titled by
the introduction to the new physics, the first part, because it is just the beginning of the big work. And my book was published in 2008. Since then, I have discovered some more things in my research, and now I'm here to share my latest discoveries, which are really complete story about anti-gravity astrophysics. And as I was using on my presentation words of Oscar Wilde, who says, if you want to tell truth to the people, make them laugh, otherwise they will kill you. So I have something really important to share with you, some important truth I have discovered, and I will try to do it in a manner with as much as possible humor. So, if I go with my humoristic bio, I can say something like this, that I work for the Secret Space Relations Agency, like a senior advisor, and what we're doing there, like a so secret agency which is not known even to the men in black, even Will Smith and Tommy Lee Jones don't know that we exist. So we do research on our relationship with the universe. So if we consider our relationship with the universe, we have to recognize that we have questionable relationship. So our questionable relationship, and we will go to that relationship through romance, suspicion, and investigation. When we consider romance part, we can say that we are in love with our universe. We love our universe, universe love us. We have abundance of light, of air, of water, of wood, of all materials we want to work with or to play with. So we are supplied with everything we need. So we love our universe, universe love us. But then comes part which is suspicion. When we consider our partner universe, we have some issues. And the issues are like this. A century ago, we have discovered, approximately a century ago, we have discovered that universe is running away from us. Spreading, running away from us. But we were believing that spreading of the universe must be at least slowing down. And we created Big Bang Theory, which will explain how that expansion started. But in 1999 and 2000, we came to conclusion and with the data that actually universe is running away from us faster and faster. And that's a really serious issue. When you see that your partner not just running away from you, but running faster and faster, that means your relationship is in trouble. Another issue which we have discovered, that our universe looks younger than many of the stars we can see. So our calculations gave us results that some stars are old 16, 17 to 20 billions of years, and the same way of calculation gave us that the universe is 10 to 12 billions of years old. And we are coming to the very strange situation that mother looks younger than daughters. So when you have a partner which looks younger than her or his own children, that's something very suspicious. And the worst thing we have in our relationship with the universe is that the universe shows us only 4 to 5% of its material existence. Everything else we call dark matter, which we consider something up to 27%, and everything else up to 100% we call dark energy. So our partner universe doesn't want to show us more than 4 to 5%. So something is really wrong with our relationship with the universe. But what are we going to do about it? So now, purpose of our agency is to tell all human beings that we can't just walk away from that relationship, because where we will go? We are living in a universe which is immense in dimensions, so we cannot just leave. Also, all property belongs to the universe. So, even we can't take anything with us, because all property belongs to the universe. What we suggest how to deal with this situation is to find a big mirror and to carefully look at ourselves. What are we doing and how we behave in that relationship? Now, what we can see, and can we find something wrong with us? And when we look at ourselves, we see that we all the time, we are coming to always wrong conclusions. The first wrong conclusion was that Earth is flat. So we were believing that we live on a planet which is just like a plate, flat. Later on, we have discovered that it is not the truth, that we actually live on a planet which is round. We were seeing sun and moon all the time in the sky, sun during the day, moon during the night, and we were seeing that they are round, but somehow we couldn't understand that we must be round, this planet must be round as well. Then we came to the conclusion that everything we have seen, sun and moon rotating, and we have seen also stars moving, so we came to conclusion then that all celestial bodies are rotating around us. So we created a geocentric system which had Earth in the center of rotation of all celestial bodies. Thanks to Copernicus and thanks to Galileo, who started to observe celestial bodies to telescope and invention of telescope, we came to understanding that actually Sun is the center of the our system, that Sun is in the center, and that we are just one of the planets rotating around the Sun. Another wrong assumption we made is that only Sun has planets, because we couldn't see anything else. Wrong conclusion we also made is that only our Sun has the planets. But so far, today, we have discovered almost 3 million of extrasolar planets. So that comes to be pattern that all stars has planets. Then we also came to conclusion that only our Milky Way galaxy exists. Now we can see that universe is full of galaxies. So far in our visible universe, we can see 100 billions of galaxies, and approximately every galaxy has 100 billions of stars. So when we count stars in the universe, that's an astronomical number. We believe that our partner, universe, is violent from the very beginning, from the very birth, coming to existence to the Big Bang. Then we believe that our partner universe is serial killer, detonating hydrogen bombs in the stars all the time. We came to conclusion that our partner universe is dark cycle, has black holes eating everything around them. That our partner universe is schizophrenic. We came to ideas that it's multiverse. Then we believe that our star and other stars are impotent, unfertile, unable to create their own planetary system, that always need some other stars, supernovas, which will explode somewhere on a very far distance and send material to the every other star to create its own system. But we do believe that our planets are potent to enable to kill planets and the systems, especially in the phase of red giant. And of course we do believe that our partner universe is always ready to kill us, sending us asteroids, comets or meteorites. So as we can see, our relationship to our partners is also very problematic. We all the time misunderstand the universe, and that's really not nice from us. When we consider all this, we have to do investigation. What's actually going on? The most serious issue we have is dark matter, missing matter of the universe. As a part of the universe, we on Earth, we must have building blocks of the universe. So when we do research here on Earth, what is the most dominant material which creates this planet, we always discover sand, rocks, stones, and even if we dig very, very deep, we will come to the liquid stones, which are magma, which are below this cold layer on the surface. So we always see that lava is predominant material, or liquid stone. So we do live on a planet which is basically liquid lava body with a tiny crust of the cold stones. When we consider what we have in our solar system, we know that we have this asteroid belt, big asteroid belt, which is located between the orbit of Mars and Jupiter, but we also have the groups of the asteroids on a distance of the Jupiter. So we see asteroids here, but we do also see asteroids beyond the planet of, beyond the orbit of Pluto, and even further, one more big belt of asteroids. So asteroids are cold rocks, are everywhere around the stars. So what we can see is that liquid rock in a form of a planet covered with a tiny cold crust, comparing with the egg, it's tinier than the shell of egg, and the cold rocks are everywhere around every star. Then we have to understand what our sun is, and then we go to the videos which we made before to see really what we can see now using our satellites, how we can see the sun. When we see that videos and we just come to the logical conclusions what we are looking at, we are looking at a liquid boiling magma. The very simple and obvious conclusion is that all that rocks which rotate around the stars in form of planets and asteroids just are coming from the body of the star, which is also made of the liquid boiling magma. So we have to understand that pattern, what we see here also must work above, and also what works above must work here, the both ways. And also on the videos we have presented, we seen that stars always blow their atmospheres away, creating solar winds. And the question is, which force creates that solar winds? We know that all planets by gravity hold their atmospheres around the planets, and in the case of the stars we clearly see that atmosphere of the sun is blown away and leaking away from the sun, creating solar wind. And the simple answer for that question is anti-gravity force. How is anti-gravity force created? I have mentioned that fire is anti-gravity phenomena, and then I discovered the relativity of the mass according to temperature. So we have existence of mass, like a feature of the matter, is attractive when matter is cold enough, but also can decrease its attraction, attractivity, and become repulsive if temperature is high enough. So on a high temperature, in a gas state of the matter, we have repulsive mass of the molecules of the gas. That is the reason, and that is the cause why we see the stars, and especially our sun, we can see our sun clearly, blows away that hot matter, because that hot matter in a gas state has molecules with a repulsive mass, and as star holds all the whole bodies, planets cold enough, and asteroids in a orbiting rotation, also by gravity force, in anti-gravity interaction, sun repels that material in gas state. But if we just change now main building material of the universe from hydrogen to liquid stone, we, from the problem of missing mass, entering the problem of too much mass. And that means that we also have to understand something more. To solve this problem, we have to do experiments. Actually, we have to see experiment which is done on the space station Mir, and that experiment we will see in the also previously recorded video about the water rotating in the zero gravity with the bubbles of air included. That video was for me key to understand really what's going on inside the stars, how stars really work. And first, I would like to explain that simple physics. There is very simple physics which explains what's going on and why bubbles, air bubbles, always come to the rotation, to the axis of rotation. So we have gravity force which hold this water in a shape of sphere. So gravity keep the shape of sphere. Bubbles which were all around the volume of the water, due to the rotation and due to the action of centrifugal force during the time of rotation and dynamic, will come and make this cylinder along the axis of rotation. The physics is very simple. Gravity force from outside and centrifugal force from inside creates in this area and in this area bigger pressure, which push the all bubbles push towards the axis of rotation, where is the pressure lowest. So we have seen that on video, and we always have that pattern. What's going on when we implement this understanding to the liquid boiling magma star? Then we come to this, and this is my drawing, which is shown first time on my presentation, showing how really star works. As we can see, because of constant boiling of magma inside the sun, not just that this cylinder is created, but in a hot state of matter, when we have constant boiling, we have constant increase in quantity of gas. That pressure of the gas inside the sun will create chamber, and that chamber will be under big pressure, with a tendency to become bigger and bigger. So that pressure must be released somehow. And the weakest point in the body of the star is the north and south pole. Because of the same effect that around axis of rotation, the cylinder of the gas is created, but liquid, due to the very strong gravity force, try to hold, to close that openings, and at the same time, the increasing pressure from the chamber of the sun try to release its pressure. So we will have on a boat south and north pole, we will have pulsation of that openings. So we will have opening, pulsating, closing and opening and closing and opening. So we have sun boiling on the outer surface and we have boiling in the outer surface. We have outer solar wind and we have inner solar wind. Outer solar wind is what we clearly see on the photos and videos made by our satellites. But this inner solar wind, which is not obvious to us, create this chamber, and basically every star functions like an anti-gravity furnace, releasing pressure to the south and north pole. And we actually see that streaming of the gases on south and north pole is at least 3 times faster than at the other surface of the sun. So basically we can see that. But this dynamic shows that stars has big hollow inside. What else can support this understanding of the star? When we look at the sky, we see many stars. We call them pulsars, and we can recognize them exactly by their specific frequency of pulsation. What actually happens and why we see some stars like pulsars? Actually, we see the same kind of, there is only one kind of stars. All stars works outwardly and inwardly according to this drawing, but some of the stars in the universe we see from our point of view, we see from their direction of north or south pole, and then we see them like a different kind, but there is no different kind of star. It is the same kind of star which just is seen by direction of south or north pole. If we send our sons to see our sun from the south or north pole, we will see the same. So we do not have many different kind of stars like we do believe now. We have only one kind of star which works like this, but they are different in size and they are different in age. So, when we consider planets, what the planets are, then we have to go to this drawing, which shows the planets. Planets are liquid magma, which is not boiling, it's liquid but not boiling, and has cold crust. So, it's covered in the shelf, in the shell. Openings exist because during the creation of planet, everything was created, chamber was created the same way like in the star, but because of cooling down, these openings are stable and open. So in the case of planets, we have openings all the time. This line here in the middle just shows that this is the center of gravity. This is not the center because center is hollow. So this is the center of gravity on the planet, and we have the situation that all planets and all stars are hollow. So all celestial bodies are hollow. When we come to that conclusion and that realization, then we don't have too much mass. So the universe is liquid, made of liquid magma, boiling magma in case of stars, and just liquid magma in case of planets. And when we consider that they are also hollow inside, then we don't have any problem anymore with a missing or extra mass. To support also this model of the star, I will go back to the appearance of our solar system. So this is the Sun in the middle, and then beyond the orbit of Pluto we have first big belt of asteroids, which we call Kuiper belt, which is in form of disk. But much further beyond, we have another much bigger belt of the asteroids, which we call Oort cloud. How they came to existence? As planets came to existence from the explosions from the Sun surface, these asteroids from the Kuiper belt also came from explosions and eruptions from the surface of the Sun, outer surface. The origin of this cloud, Oort cloud, which is much further, is drops of magma which was launched through the openings of the star on the north and south pole. So as we can see on this drawing, when gases are blown, you know, through these openings, also hot and very speed gases take with them small drops of magma, and that drops go with a very high speed and they reach much fire distance, which creates Oort oblak. So Oort oblak, Oort cloud, was created through the openings of the north and south pole of the star. And it is exactly what we can see. It is patterned how every solar system looks. Planets around, cloud beyond the planets, and then another cloud much, much wider, which much more asteroids, which holds the whole system in a sphere. What I'm talking about on this my presentation is just different explanation of what we can see. So I, in my observations, because I cannot call this theory because it is not done by any calculations and mathematical procedures, it's done through observation and through different understanding of data we collect with all our experiments. So we came to the point now that we have to change again almost everything we know. If we didn't understand what the Sun and what the stars are, then the next question is what we really did understand well. And what I'm talking about is clearly visible. It's simple and logical. If we can see rocks here on our planet, below the cold surface, we see liquid, that pattern must also work in the universe. So we live in the universe, which is a liquid boiling magma. And when we consider size of the celestial bodies, and we have recorded a video showing how big celestial bodies can be, we see that in the scale of size, our Earth is just like a tiny grain of sand. according to the biggest star we have discovered so far. The origin of the stars is that bigger stars create smaller stars. And when the star becomes so small, like our sun, that cannot create any other star, it creates just a planets around and asteroids. And the best shot, the best try of our sun to create another star was Jupiter. Jupiter, what we now consider like a gas planet, is not gas planet. It's a planet made again of liquid magma, but which is not cold on the surface. So Jupiter is big enough not to be like other planets, to have cold crust, cold surface, and not hot enough and not big enough to become another star. So Jupiter is something is between planet and star. And in the course of time, Jupiter can become another small star, as we can see that the universe is spreading. That means that energy become stronger and stronger. So we can expect that in some distant future, Jupiter can become another small star. And that's the very simple way how we again have to rediscover our universe. As everything came to be simple after changing position of the sun in the center of the rotation of the, our solar system, when from the epicycles, which were complicated trajectories of planets, when Earth is in center, we come to the heliocentric system where everything is almost circles. We are now coming again to the very simple solution that as planets and asteroids are made of stones, stars are also made of liquid magma, liquid stones, and we again have same single simple pattern which only can work in the universe. This is just a beginning, and what I did with my presentation is sharing for first time of my latest discoveries. My intention is to put this to the public knowledge and to give information to scientists, to philosophers, because we are now going to start another big discussion where we have to change almost everything we know today with something new, which will come to very simple form and very effective form. So I am open to all questions, and you can see here. So for the video, this video on YouTube, also the I expect video to come from the deathchannel.com. This is my website where we can, where anybody can see my book and download my book for free. This is the site is thenewphysics.com. This is my Gmail address, thenewphysics@gmail.com, for questions or contact. Also here in Toronto, I have created the meetup group, which is revolutionary new paradigm creators, so that everybody who is in Toronto can join and we can continue with our work, because this is just the beginning of the big work on the creation of totally new physics. I call it new physics, but maybe we can call it anti-gravity physics. And I will also create some web group for people all around the world, so that we can meet, we'll see how often, and discuss all these issues on the web conferences. Thank you very much for your attention, and I wish you all the best, and I hope that you will understand simplicity and logic in what I'm saying. Thank you very much.
The next conference will be in Toronto in October.
Yes, I do plan to organize another presentation in October. We'll see exactly which date here in Toronto, when all the professors and the students are back. My first presentation was in the middle of summer, July 25th, and this was the maybe unlucky case, but this is just the beginning. After seeing this video, I expect that things will come and change, and we will proceed in our creation of new physics and new philosophy. Whenever we change something big in science, we always have change in our philosophy, in our understanding, and our paradigm of thinking.
Nita, good luck and good night.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And see you next time.